So after finishing the recording of You Are we toured extensively through that whole campaign. It was incredible. The response for the album was mental. We scheduled in to play in America with Trivium and Arch Enemy. It was sick. We were stoked to get back out to America. Hadn't been there for a little while. Previously been there with the Architects, Bullet for Valentine, and done some warp tours. So yeah, we were stoked and ready to get back out there and play.
I personally and the rest of the lads really consciously try and meet as many people as we can, and I've been quite fed up for a while of this strange illusion between the whole music industry and then the fans being like quite a separate thing. These people love our music and we love making music, so to keep that connection as real and as close as possible, that's what I want to do. And for me, that's what You Are We means to me more than anything.
Riffs in this.
We should go on stage in a moment.
Oh, God dang it. So quickly through countries and through different places, it's easy to become overwhelmed at how many modern settlements there is everywhere and quite how massive civilization is. I sometimes find it quite overwhelming when you're just constantly moving through these little towns or cities, and to kind of get to New York, it's just a bit of a terrifying reminder of the kind of beast that mankind has created.
Driving straight to Calgary, but it's a colossal drive.
Maybe we'll see a few mountains.
Going up into Canada, I think everyone felt a bit of fresh air and a bit of like, after being in such a busy part of the world, it was nice to sort of get some room to breathe.
One of the most exciting parts of North America for us is Canada, and one, because there's so much amazing scenery and open space there. And every time we've been, the shows have been just insane, and everyone we've met there has been really cool. So we were just stoked to get back, and they definitely didn't disappoint. The shows were ridiculous.
We had a couple of friends from back at home as well who live in Vancouver. It was really nice to see them. We get to see them like once every year now, so to see them in their hometown was great. We went to some bars and had a good time.
What a rush.
fuck's sake.
Here he is. Becca. Hello?
Sorry, dude.
We hit California just in time for Matt's birthday, and we definitely had a few tricks up our sleeve.
Just prepping for that surprise party.
Phase one complete. It's gonna work. So while we took Matt out for his birthday meal, Loz stayed behind and pretended to be on vocal rest. But actually, he's staying behind so he can set up the decorations for Matt's surprise birthday party he has no idea about. Disaster almost struck when Loz wasn't responding to my warning text messages that we were 2 minutes away.
Because he's not responding, he's not read the warning message or anything.
I thought we screwed everything up, but it worked out.
We're
going back to the old school.
We're on fucking holiday!
After our long journey, it was time to head home. Before the year was out, we had one more show left, our hometown Sheffield show. It's amazing to come home to family and friends after being away for so long, and a hometown show really welcomed us.
First birthday!
It completely blew us away. It was without a doubt the best show we've ever played.
I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
I've been everywhere. I'm an idiot sandwich.
You're a stupid sandwich.
I'm a stupid sandwich.
Now,